During the summer of 2003, events in the northeastern United States involved a strange, human-like creature, sparking brief local media interest, before an apparent blackout was enacted. Little or no information was left intact, as for most online and written accounts of the creature, they were mysteriously destroyed. Primarily focused in rural New York State, and once found in Idaho, self-proclaimed witnesses told stories of their encounters with a creature of unknown origin. Emotions ran from extremely traumatic levels of fright and discomfort to an almost childlike sense of playfulness and curiosity. While their published versions are no longer on record, the memories remained powerful. Several of the involved parties began looking for answers that year. In early 2006, the collaboration had accumulated nearly 24 documentaries dating between the 12th century and present day, spanning 4 continents. In all cases, the stories were identical. I've been in contact with the members of this group and were able to get some excerpts from their upcoming book. A note from 1964. As I prepare to take my life, I feel it's necessary to assuage any guilt or pain that I have introduced through this act. It is not the fault of anyone other than him. And once I awoke and I saw his form, once again I awoke and heard his voice and looked into his eyes. I cannot sleep without fear of what I might next awake to experience. I cannot ever wake. Goodbye. Found in the same wooden box were 2 empty envelopes addressed to William and Rose, and 1 loose personal letter with no envelope. Dearest Lynn, I've prayed for you. He spoke your name. A journal entry, translated from Spanish. 1880. I have experienced the greatest terror. I see his eyes when I close mine. They are hollow, black. They saw me and pierced me. His wet hand, I will not sleep. His voice. And there in his log. 1691.
He came to me in my sleep. From the foot of my bed, I felt a sensation. He took everything. He must return to England. He shall not return here again at the request of the Rake.
From a witness. 2006. 3 years ago, I had just returned from a trip from Niagara Falls with my family on the 4th of July. We were all very exhausted after a long day of driving, so my husband and I put the kids right to bed and called it a night. At 4 a.m., I woke up thinking my husband had gotten up to use the restroom. I used the moment to steal back the sheets, only to wake him in the process. I apologized and told him I thought that he got out of bed. When he turned to face me, he gasped and he pulled his feet up from the end of the bed so quickly his knee almost knocked me out of the bed. He then grabbed me and said nothing. After adjusting to the dark for half a second, I was able to see what caused the strange reaction. At the foot of the bed, sitting and facing away from us, there was what appeared to be a naked man, or a large hairless dog of some sort. Its body position was disturbing and unnatural, as if it had been hit by a car or something. For some reason, I was not instantly frightened by it, but more concerned as to its condition. At this point, I was somewhat under the assumption that we were supposed to help him. My husband was peering over his arm and knee, tucked into the fetal position, occasionally glancing at me before returning to the creature. In a flurry of motion, the creature scrambled around the side of the bed, then clawed quickly in a flailing sort of motion right along the bed until it was less than a foot from my husband's face. The creature was completely silent for about 30 seconds, or probably closer to 5. It just seemed like a while, just looked at my husband. The creature then placed its hand on his knee and ran into the hallway, leading to the kid's room. I screamed and I ran for the light switch, planning to stop him before he hurt my children. When I got to the hallway, the light from the bedroom was enough to see. He was crouching, hunched over, about 20 feet away. He turned around and he looked directly at me, covered in blood, and I flipped the switch on. I saw my daughter, Clara. The creature ran down the stairs while my husband and I rushed to help our daughter. She was very badly injured, and she spoke only once more in her short life. She said he is the Rake. My husband drove his car into a lake that night, rushing our daughter to the hospital. They did not survive. Being a small town, news got around pretty quick. The police were helpful at first, and the local newspaper took a lot of interest as well. However, the story was never published. Local television news never followed up either. For several months, my son Justin and I stayed in a hotel near my parents' house. After we decided to return home, I began looking for answers myself, and I eventually located a man in the next town over who had a similar story. We got in contact. We began talking about our experiences. He knew of two other people in New York who had seen the creature that we now referred to as the Rake. It took the four of us about 2 solid years of hunting on the internet, writing letters to come up with a small collection of what we believed to be accounts of the Rake. None of them gave any details, history, or follow-up. One journal had an entry involving the creature in its first 3 pages and never mentioned it again. A ship's log explained nothing of the encounter, saying only that they were told to leave by the Rake. That was the last entry in the log. There were, however, many instances where the creature's visits were one of a series of visits with the same person. Multiple people also mentioned being spoken to, my daughter included. This led us to wonder if the Rake had visited any of us before our last encounter. I set up a digital recorder near my bed, and I left it running all night, every night, for 2 weeks. I would tediously scan through sounds of me rolling around in my bed each day. And by the end of the 2nd week, I was quite used to the occasional sound of sleep while blurring through the recordings at 8 times the normal speed. It still took almost an hour every day. On the 1st day of the 3rd week, I thought I heard something different. What I found was a shrill voice. It was the Rake. I can't listen to it long enough to even begin to transcribe it. I haven't let anyone listen to it. All I know is that I've heard it before, and I now believe that it spoke when it was sitting in front of my husband. I don't remember hearing anything at the time, but for some reason, the voice on the recorder immediately brings me back to that moment. The thoughts that must have gone through my daughter's head make me very upset. I haven't seen the Rake since he ruined my life, but I know that he has been in my room while I slept. I know, and I fear that one night I'll wake up to him, and I'll see him staring at me. Hey there kids, it's me, Mr. Creepypasta, and I just wanted to tell you thank you for watching tonight's video. Because this is October, I'm going to make this nice, short, and sweet. If you'd like to help support the show or the podcast, head over to patreon.com/MrCreepyPasta. If you'd like to get yourself some new Halloween and creepypasta-inspired tees, you can head over to etsy.com/shop/ivory-monocle-tee. And if you want to catch me, CreepsMcPasta, and Myuu during our live Halloween tour around the southern U.S., head over to creepypasta.shofetti.com. That's creepypasta.shofetti.com. Hang on to your hats, kids, because this year is a 31-day Halloween countdown. Happy Halloween and sweet dreams.